Send as me.
Bunsin. Debina. Liying.
Balita. Bekai.
Visa.
Bekian.
Akia.
Bishin.
Ufini.
Yongsan. Yichun.
Yiwei.
Hello everyone, we Eco Squad realize that the importance of green environment is often being ignored by our community. Regarding to this matter, we have decided to bring the awareness of unhealthy environment and work together for a healthy life in line with our university lifestyle, Eco Campus. So let us join hands this 9 October at Tanjung Lipat to protect our beloved nature. And again, I am
the leader of Eco Squad!
Eco Squad TV. It is Friday, November 4, 2016. I am Lo Bun Sin and
I'm Woman Engineer Mak Termizi reporting from University of Malaysia Sabah. On 9 October 2016, 15 students from University of Malaysia Sabah had executed their CSR project titled Cleaning the Beach in Tanjung Lipat.
Calling themselves the Eco Squad, this group of 15 students did their corporate social responsibility CSR in Tanjung Lipat to spread the awareness of clean environment to our society, especially in a public and commercial place like Tanjung Lipat. They arrived on destination around 8 a.m. and ended their visits at 12 p.m.
Tanjung Lipat is known for its recreation use, but unfortunately, this beach is filled with dirty trash. Regarding to this matter, Eco Squad have decided to visit the place and do a community service. Activities such as cleaning the beach with the local, giving free trash bags to the local visitors, collecting public signature to show signs of supporting the CSR project, and interviewing the locals and also the area's worker will help.
Here are the clips of reporter Najmi and his team, which were taken on 9 October 2016, interviewing the locals and the area workers.
Okey, terima kasih kepada rakan-rakan di studio. Dan sekarang ini saya berada di kawasan perkarangan Tanjung Lipat. Dan sekarang saya akan menemu ramah beberapa orang di kawasan ini. So, dengan siapa saya nak temu ramah? Jom ikut saya.
Yes, sir.
Ya, okay, boleh tak bagi satu mesej? Korang satu mesej? Tentang CSR ni, apa harapan lah untuk generasi yang akan datang.
Okay, bagi aku generasi akan datang, saya berharap sangat agar kamu mengikuti program tersebut dan tidak mengira bayaran dan apa-apa pun. Buat secara ikhlas dan cuba mengubah diri kita untuk generasi yang akan datang supaya orang apa-apa, bersih tempatnya, sudah bersihkan tempat. So, generasi akan datang pergi tempat ini dia akan yakin, oh bersih, so kami akan ikut membersihkan tersebut.
Sampah
ni bukan dari sini lah, yang
senang
je ni kan.
Yeah.
Daripada yang perkampungan
tinggal
tu kan, jadi dia terdampar di sini.
Tapi masih first time datang ni kan?
Iya.
Yeah. Jadi first time lah, macam tidak selalu lah. Ada juga datang,
tapi tidak selalu. Tapi selalunya dipenuhi sampah?
Tidak juga. Kalau kosan sini dia bersih kan, sebab ada pekerja kan.
Dia biasanya di itu, di pendepan
di air tu. Iya, itu kan. Kamu boleh tengok itu sana.
Iya.
So, Encik, apa harapan Encik lah macam kepada universiti luar tentang apa yang mereka perlu buat, apa boleh mereka boleh buat untuk
jaga kebersihan?
Itulah DBK harap-harap ini pembersihan di sini berterusan dengan begini keadaan dia lah, yang bersih dan tidak ada aduan daripada orang awam yang mengatakan pantai.
Okey, itu saja lintas langsung di kawasan perkarangan Tanjung Lipat daripada saya, Muhammad Najmi Ahmad Tarmizi.
Razi di program khas untuk Eco Squad TV. Kembali ke studio.
Before we conclude our news, I would like to hand over the screen to our weather report, which will be reported by Yong San Lee.
Okay, thank you, Wen Xin. Hello everyone, I am Yong San Lee, reporting the weather report for the day 9 October 2016 on Tanjong Lipa from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. The weather on Tanjong Lipa that day was sometimes sunny and sometimes cloudy. This change was affected by season. During that day, there were no signs of rain, but still the wind blew quite strong and weather became cloudy on the area. The number of visitors were moderate around that time. They were family having their picnic, a group of students, and also an organization having their family days. Few locals who are fishing were also spotted around that time.
Thank you, Yong-san, for the weather report. After completing the project, we found out that the rubbish that tainted the beauty of our beach is mostly from the nearby island. According to the area's workers, 70% of the rubbish came from the nearby island and 30% are from the local visitors.
Considering this matter, we urge all of you, especially university students, to care and protect our environment. There are a lot of things or ideas that we can generate to solve this problem. It is our job to make sure that the future will be safe for the next generation. In line with our UMS Eco Campus, mengubah idea menjadi reality. And again, I'm Lo Bun Sin.
And I'm Muhammad Azmi Ahmad Tamizi.
Thank you for watching.
And have a good day. Thank you.